Welcome! You click on this video because you want to contribute to open source, but you're struggling finding the right project. Stay with me a few minutes, and I promise I'll provide you with some technical and practical steps to get you started today. A common obstacle to overcome is finding the right project. Don't worry though, it happens to all of us. Everything that comes to your mind is either a huge project where you don't know how to get started because of a deep knowledge required, or some dead projects without maintainers, they no longer review PRs, open issues, and things like that. The first step is looking at this cool resource called opensource.guide. The name is pretty much self-explanatory. This website contains a lot of guides and tips and tricks and insights on what is open source and how can you approach to this new world. Don't expect to immediately become an expert, as like everything, it takes time and practice. However, this website will give you some useful advices and insights that will help you speed up the process once you begin. Once you've got some motivation and understood the basic, I suppose you want to get started. Finding the right project is probably one of the more difficult tasks. That's why I want to share with you some advices based on my own experience to get you started today. The best way, at least it worked for me, is to thinking about the software you use on a daily basis. For example, in your day job. A really good hint could be looking at your package.json or the dependency file of your project, and you will see a long list of software you actually use, and you will be surprised in finding how many of them are actually open source. You better search on GitHub the name of the project, or for example, in the documentation website, you will find the open or fork on GitHub icon. In my case, I use VS Code as editor, and I found quite reasonable to pick that project and contribute to it. A common way to find a project you never heard of is by going backward and looking at the issues. Owners and maintainers of open source projects usually have tags on their issues that can attract and manifest the interest in having open source contributions. The labels you have to look careful at are good first issue, help wanted, and up for grabs. If you already have a project in mind, look at the issues with the labels I just mentioned. If you don't know the project, well, look at this list. All those websites are collectors of issues where you can search and filter, for example, by language, you can filter by project name, and these services will help you getting through the list and picking up some projects for you. To be honest with you, I'm not really a fan of this method because I think you need the deep knowledge of the project before contributing, or at least before making a meaningful contribution. However, I found many of those websites being quite common and popular on the internet, so I thought that I should probably mention them. They did not really work well for me, but they might work out for you. So, good luck! Once you find a project that suits you, and you think it's the right one, there are still a few steps to take before being 100% able to contribute effectively. For example, finding the right issue that addresses a particular line in the code. Make sure to subscribe to this channel, as I'm already writing the script of a video about helping you how to find the best issue to begin with after you've found the project. In the meantime, you can watch this YouTube short video that is less than 60 seconds on the practical steps on how to open a pull request. Do you have some advices for new contributors funding their project? Don't be shy, just write a comment here down below so that everyone can benefit from your own experience. And thank you very much. And that was all for today. I hope you liked this video. Let me know in the comments if you did not or if you have suggestions. Subscribe if you want to get notified about new open source content. And well, see you soon.